فؤادك الأيام فتى
إلى الخروج leaving ولم يرد منا the prophet did not want from us تأخير الصلاة delaying the salah he didn't want that from us عليه الصلاة والسلام فبلغ ذلك النبي the matter reached the prophet فلم يعنف أحدا منهم the messenger فلم يعنف أحدا منهم the prophet did not become hard on any one of them he wasn't عليه الصلاة والسلام ولم يوبخ على ما فهمهم ولم يوبخه على ما فهم ما فهم and the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he did not rebuke him for that which he understood وهم بأنفسهم رضي الله عنهم but they amongst themselves لم يتفرقوا من أجل اختلاف الرأي they did not come with disunity based on the differing that they had in terms of their views في فهم حديث رسول الله in how they understood the hadith of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم they all differed they all now pay attention here this right now here the sahabas here right now this khilaf occurred from them the khilaf that occurred from them is اختلاف الأفهام how they understood this text amongst them is those who understood it literal and amongst them was those that understood that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم meant another thing behind it and the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he did not rebuke any one of them he did not speak about any of the groups salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi so that shows that differing in some matters of the religion should not cause us to what? It should not cause disunity. It should not cause disunity. And that's something which we studied in our book, Raf'ul Malam an A'immatil A'lam, that the Sahabas differed on many matters. Are you with me? But remember, the matters that they differed on were not. And differing of these matters are not tolerated. What are they? Masail, which are qawa'id kulliyah, usul, which the religion stands upon. Comprehensive matters which are fundamental that the religion stands on. Do you guys see the fact I didn't say aqidah? Because there are matters of fiqh in which we won't tolerate for you to have differences of opinion with us. And that's not correct. The correct one is masail which are usul kulli. They are usul which are kulliyah. لا يجوز فيه الخلاف. Khilaf is not permissible for you. So aqaid matters and also some fiqh issues. Some fiqh issues which the ulama took from fiqh and they entered it into what? They entered it into the books of haqa'id. Na'am. Amma amalu salaf al-salih. Now the sheikh is bringing us what about the salaf al-salih? What about the salaf al-salih? فَإِنَّ مِنْ أُصُولِ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ فِي الْمَسَائِلِ الْخِلَافِيَّةِ أَنَّ مَا كَانَ الْخِلَافُ فِيهِ صَادِرًا عَنْ اجْتِهَادٍ وَكَانَ مِمَّا يَسُوغُ فِيهِ الْاجْتِهَادُ Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen says, as for the action of the pious predecessors, from the fundamental usul of Ahlul Sunnati is, في مسائل الخلافية, in matters which are خلافية. Khilaf is matters which differences of opinion stand. But look how powerful Shaykh puts it here. Which what? في المسائل الخلافية أنما كان الخلاف فيه صادرا The khilaf of this matter it comes from صادر it comes from an اجتهاد based on a اجتهاد a striving not ignorance لا عن جهل ولا عن عدم تملك الأداة and it's not a person who doesn't even have the آلة and the ability to do اجتهاد Are you with me? So it has to occur from a person whose issue that he is doing is from what? From ijtihad. وَكَانَ And also it is مِمَّا يَسُوغُ فِي الْإِجْتِهَادِ And it's also from those matters which ijtihad can occur from. So we need a person has to have ahliyah. The first point that the Sheikh mentioned is the person who is coming with this has to be a person who has ahliyah and he has malaka. He much grounded. He knows because he is what? Because he's an alim mujtahid. The second thing is that matter has to be from those matters mimma yasughu fi al-ijtihad. That ijtihad is, it can take place. Yasughu means what? It can occur in it, ijtihad. It can occur in it. In it. And the hearts of the people should be open in that matter. And discussing it. ولذلك الشافعي used to say, ما ناظرت أحدا, I never debated anyone. إلا وتمنيت, except I wished. أن يظهر الله, that Allah makes apparent. الحق على لساني أو على لسانه. That Allah makes the haq clear either on my tongue or the tongue of the person I'm discussing it with. I want Allah to bring it. Those matters are what like in? مسائل يسوغ فيه الاجتهاد. The ijtihad can take place. They are مسائل which يسوغ فيه الاجتهاد. Now what nowadays we find is some people who don't know the difference between مسائل which are خلافية and مسائل which are اجتهادية. Oh, they're two different things. مسائل which are خلافية, there's خلاف in it, which there's إنكار, I can reject it from you. Some people say to you, أخي لا إنكار, there is no rejection or there is no rejection on matters which are what? خلافية. مسألة خلافية, أخي there's a difference of opinions, don't force your opinion on others, let it be. And that is incorrect. That's lack of understanding. The مسائل which are لا إنكار فيه is مسألة which is based on a ijtihad and it all is based on what? Ijtihad. And what is the difference between khilaf and ijtihad? Khilaf is a matter which one has an evidence while the other one doesn't have it. One individual has an evidence. He has his evidence, here is his evidence. He's providing evidence, and the other one doesn't have that evidence. There's a khilaf. Are there differences between the two of them? Who's the one we have to follow? The one who has the evidence. The one who doesn't have the evidence, we will say to you, we're not going to accept this from you. Because of the, we are ordered to what? And that is what the one Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the ayah, وَاتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَا. Don't follow besides Allah أَوْلِيَا. وَلِذَلَكَ إِمَامُ الْقُرْطُبِ رَحِيمُ اللَّهِ in the tafsir of the ayah, he says, this is the evidence that when the ayah comes, you cannot follow, or evidence is there, you're not allowed to follow the statement of a scholar. Abu Hanifa said, or Shafi'i said, or Malik said, or Ahmed said, it is not permissible for you. But the matter which is ijtihadiyya means both of them are using the same evidence and they're both bringing out two different understandings out of it. They are all with the same evidences, but the way they are applying it, or one is using a hadith and one sees that hadith to be da'if and one sees it now to be sahih. These are masail which are what? Ijtihadiyya. Ijtihadiyya. And that is what we have to understand. Those matters, Ibn Uthaymeen now mentions to you, فَإِنَّ بَعْضَهُمْ يَعْذُرُ بَعْضًا بِالْخِلَافِ. Some of them would excuse others in the disagreement of this matter. They would excuse one another. وَلَا يَحْمِلُ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ حِقْدًا. And some of them will not carry for the others hate. وَلَا عَدَاوَةً. And no enmity. وَلَا بَغْضًا. And a hate. حِقْدًا. عَدَاوَةً. بَغْضًا are close in meaning. It is hate, enmity. Na'am. They won't have a grudge against that person or hate or enmity at all. بَلْ رَاذَا يَعْتَقِدُونَ. They believe أَنَّهُمْ إِخْوَةٌ. They believe that they are brothers. حَتَّى even وَإِنْ حَصَلَ بَيْنُهُمْ هَذَا الْخِلَافِ. Even if the differences occurs between them in this matter. They love one another. حَتَّى إِنَّ الْوَاحِدَ مِنْهُمْ. To the extent that one of them will pray. لا يصلي خلف من يرى. He will pray behind the one he sees. أنه ليس على وضوء. The one who he sees that is not upon wudu. He will pray behind him. And here it doesn't mean, you have to understand it, is that some madhabs may believe that the aklu lahmi ibilin, the eating of the meat of the camel breaks wudu, and another madhab may not believe it. Are you with me? And when we were studying qawa'id al-fiqhiyya, this mas'ala, it requires what? A tafriq, it has to be clarified. Which is what? If a person is leading the salah, and he believes with you, that camel breaks the wudu. He believes that with you. Are you with me? That individual who has that conclusion with you, but disagrees whether what he ate was a camel meat or not, you're not allowed to pray behind him. If a person, he says to you, Akhi, I believe you have to do wudu from camel meat, like you do. And I see that to be the strongest view. Good. But what we ate was not camel meat. And there's no one to what? There is no one to answer that for you. Or to be able to give you guys a answer. Based on that, you are not allowed to pray behind him. He has a wudu. But if he says to you, the issue of the camel meat, whether it breaks the wudu, it's not the correct view. I hold the view that says it doesn't break your wudu. So based on that, I believe, and he sees that your view is nasikh, huh? Your view is mansukh, sorry, it's abrogated, and that his view abrogated your ruling, and based on the masail and the khilaf that's amongst the fuqaha in this issue, Sheikh says they will pray behind each other in this issue, because it's from the masail which are what? Is masail which are khilafiyyah yasuru fi al-ijtihad. The ijtihad here is something that can come. Na'am. They will pray behind each other. They would what? They would. وَيَرَى الْإِمَامُ And the imam would see أَنَّهُ عَلَى وُضُوءٍ Even though he's not on wudu, he sees that he's on wudu. مثل أن يصلي خلف شخص أكل لحم إبل. It's like praying behind a person who ate the camel meat. وهذا الإمام and this imam يرى he sees أنه لا ينقض الوضوء that the camel meat does not break the wudu. والمأموم the one that's praying behind the imam يرى he sees أنه ينقض الوضوء that it breaks the wudu. فيرى أن الصلاة So he sees that the prayer خلف ذلك الإمام صحيحة But he sees that the prayer behind this imam is correct. وإن كان even that though هو لو صلاها بنفسه Even that though if he was to pray by himself لا رأى أن صلاته غير صحيحة He would have seen his own prayer to be incorrect. If he prayed that salah without the wudu by himself he would consider that prayer to be invalid because he prayed without a tahara but he gives this imam a different ruling كل هذا all of that لأنهم because يرون they see أن الخلاف الناشئ because they believe that the disagreement الناشئ the word ناشئ means what it stems from عن اجتهاد it stems from اجتهاد striving فيما يسوغ فيه الاجتهاد something that the اجتهاد can occur from ليس في الحقيقة بخلاف ليس but في الحقيقة in reality ليس it is not في الحقيقة in reality بخلاف أي خلاف and I mentioned the difference between the two لأن كل واحد من المختلفين because the two individuals who are disagreeing قَدْ اتَّبَعَ مَا يَجِبُ عَلَيْهِ اتِّبَاعُهُ Because both of the individuals, they followed that which was obligatory on them to follow. مِنَ الدَّلِيلِ From the evidence. الَّذِي لَا يَجُوزُ لَهُ الْعُدُولُ عَنُ The evidence in which it's not permissible for him to divert from. Each person has followed the evidence. He took your evidence, he explained it, that's abrogated. So he hasn't left except he, and I said this before, that is the difference between ijtihad and khilaf. Whereas the khilaf, he hasn't come to your evidence. You have a ziyadatu ilmin. You have an additional evidence which he doesn't have. And you see, at this point, at this particular point, the one who has the evidence takes precedence over the one who doesn't have the evidence. But if he explains your evidence, he explains your evidence, and this is mas'ala mukhtalafun fihi, there's a dispute. Then based on that, everyone has followed the evidence. They've applied the qawa'id that were there, they applied the usul that were there, and they came with different results. This is a khilafun. It's a khilaf. An-nash'a al-ijtihadi fima yasugu fihi al-ijtihad. Very good. No one's diverted from it. فَهُمْ يَرَوْنَ they see أَنَّ أَخَاهُمْ إِذَا خَالَفَهُمْ that their brother, if he disagrees with them, في عَمَلٍ مَا in any matter, in any action, اتِّبَاعًا لِلدَّلِيلِ but whilst following the evidence, هُوَ فِي الْحَقِيقَةِ they see that in reality he is قَدْ وَافَقَهُمْ he agreed with them. Even though he came with different results, they still believe that the brother is with them. Why? Because he follows the مَزْدَرُ التَّلَقِي with them. He takes from the kitab and the sunnah بِفَهْمِ سَلَفِ الْأُمَّةِ The qawa'id and the usool kulli are all intact and they're all together. But the results are different. What do they see here? What do they see? They see that you and him have not differed. Rather, you have agreed. لِأَنَّهُمْ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى اتِّبَاعِ الدَّلِيلِ Because each person is calling to what? They are calling to the dalil to be followed. أَيْنَمَا كَانَ Wherever the evidence is. فَإِذَا خَالَفَهُمْ If he differs with them, فَإِذَا خَالَفَهُمْ مُوَافَقَةً لِدَلِيلٍ عِنْدَهُ فَهُوَ فِي الْحَقِيقَةِ قَدْ وَافَقَهُمْ Because if he differs with them, مُوَافَقَةً لِدَلِيلٍ in agreement with an evidence to him, in reality, he has only agreed with them. لِأَنَّهُ because تَمَشَّى عَلَى مَا يَدْعُونَ إِلَيْهِ وَيَهْدُونَ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ تَحْكِيمِ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَسُنَّةِ رَسُولِهِ Because they are all treading عَلَى مَا يَدْعُونَ إِلَيْهِ Every one of them is treading and calling to what? To the kitab and the sunnah. And that which is وَيَهْدُونَ إِلَيْهِ And they are following it. The kitab and the sunnah, what it's calling to is what they are following. The guidance of the kitab and the sunnah is what they are following. من تحكيم كتاب الله تعالى وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's the first type, which is خلاف. Yeah, أما اجتهاد خلاف يسوغ فيه الاجتهاد. What about that one which a خلاف can't occur from it? أما ما لا يسوغ فيه الخلاف. As for that which one which خلاف cannot occur from. فهو ما كان مخالفا لما كان عليه الصحابة والتابعون and this is the one which is in opposition to that which the Sahabas and the تابعون were upon كمسائل العقائد like matters of عقيدة التي ضل فيها من ضل من الناس who became misguided a group of people became based on this in عقيدة ولم يحصل فيها الخلاف إلا بعد القرون المفضلة and the خلاف did not occur except after the three noble generations أي لم ينتشر الخلاف the خلاف did not spread إلا بعد القرون المفضلة after the virtuous generations وإن كان بعض الخلاف even that though some of the dispute فيها موجودا even that though some of the disagreement was present in the time of the Sahaba, even though it was present. Like the situation of the Khawarij and the Qadariya, they came out at the time of the Sahabas. ولكن even that though they were at the time of the Sahabas, لكن ليعلم أننا إذا قلنا قرن الصحابة ليس المعنى أنه لابد أن يموت كل صحابة بل القرن ما وجد فيه معظم أهله. The Sheikh said, he's trying to explain that when he said that this khilaf was not present at the time of the noble generation, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen is trying to tell, what we mean by that is, and that you should keep in mind and know, is that when we say that this matter was not present at the three noble generation, it means, ليس المعنى, it doesn't mean, أنه لا بد أن يموت كل صحابة, that every sahabi has to die, بل القرن, rather the generation is, ما وجد فيه معظم أهله, that which the majority of its people were upon. قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية said إن القرن a generation يحكم بانقضائه إذا انقرض أكثر أهله. A generation is called when the majority of those people pass away. That's a generation. إن القرن يحكم. A generation is considered بانقضائه, coming to an end, إذا انقرض أكثر أهله, when the majority of his people perish or they go. Meaning there may have been some Sahabas that saw the Khawarij or that saw the Qadariya, but compare that to the ones who died from the Sahabas, which one were more? When the Khawarij came out, whether a lot of Sahabas alive or were there little Sahabas alive? They were little in comparison to those who died. And when the Qadariya came out, were there a lot of the Sahabas alive or the great elder Sahabas, they passed away, they died? Na'am. So that was not present at the time of the Sahabas, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. That was the noble generation. فَالْقُرُونُ الْمُفَضَّلَةُ انْقَرَضَتْ. The noble generations, they went. وَلَمْ يُوجَدْ فِيهَا هَذَا الْخِلَافُ. And this dispute was not found. الَّذِي انْتَشَرَ بَعْدَهُمْ. That which spread after them in matters of aqa'id. I mean, the Sahabas didn't see this. فَمَنْ خَالَفَ مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّحَابَةُ وَالتَّابِعُونَ. Anyone who goes against that which the Sahabas and the Tabi'een were upon, فَإِنَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَا يُقْبَلُ خِلَافُهُ. It is on him and his dispute is not accepted from him. If anybody comes and opposes that which the Sahabas and the Tabi'een were upon, his disagreement is not taken into consideration and it's not accepted from him. أَمَّا الْمَسَائِلِ. As for the matters, الَّتِي وُجِدَ فِيهَا الْخِلَافُ فِي أَحْدِ الصَّحَابَةِ. As for the issues which the disagreement was present at the time of the Sahabas, وَكَانَ فِيهَا, and in it was what? مَسَاغُ لِلِجْتِهَادِ. There was a window for what? To dispute one another. There was a room for to strive. فَلَا بُدَّ أَن يَكُونَ الْخِلَافُ فِيهَا بَاقِيًا. That khilaf has to remain. Meaning no one can say that khilaf, it died with those Sahabas, once they're dead, it's gone. No. لا يموت القول بموت قائله. A speech does not die because the individual who said it died. It will carry on. So that khilaf, if somebody sticks to that issue to today, they won't make a fuss out of it. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. When we say we won't make a fuss out of it, we mean that we will discuss the matter. And we may even, but there will still be love and there will still be brotherhood and the unity will still stand. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Messenger said, إذا حكم الحاكم. If the judges, فاجتهد, and he strives, فأصاب, and he gets it right, فله أجران, he has two rewards. وإن اجتهد, if he strives, فأخطأ, and he gets it wrong, فله أجر, he only has one reward. فهذا هو الضابط. That is the ضابط for this issue. So what is it? The ضابط, we have to understand, is very important. The ضابط is أن يكون الخلاف فيما يسوغ الخلاف فيه. The matter has to be a matter that khilaf can occur regarding it. We can't talk about a matter which has a nas sarih. Evidence is out there. That one, no. وَأَنْ يَكُونَ وَاقِعًا مِمَّنْ يَمْلِكُ أَدَاءَ الْإِخْتِلَافِ. And the second point is what? That it has to occur from a person who has the instruments to do ijtihad. لكن بكر من الناس زيد العمر. He does ijtihad and his ijtihad is considered? No, not at all. A jahil, ignorant individual can't do ijtihad. He can't say, إذا حكم الحاكم فاجتهد فأصاب فله أجران وإن اجتهد فأخطأ فله أجر. And he bases it on himself? No. We mentioned what the ضابط is. The ضابط is أن يكون الخلاف فيما يسوغ الخلاف فيه. The matter has to be something that الخلاف can occur regarding it. Which is that there's no نص صريح in this issue. There's no نص صريح in this issue. The second one is أن يكون واقع ممن يملك أداة الاختلاف. A person who has instrumental, he has the آلة and he has the ملكة. It comes from him. Those two you have to always remember. فالواجب على المسلمين جميعا. It is obligatory on the Muslims, wherever they are, all of them, أن يكونوا أمة واحدة. That they are all one nation. وألا يحصل بينهم التفرق وألا يحصل بينهم تفرق وتحزب, that it doesn't occur between them disunity and becoming sects and groups. يتناحرون فيما بينهم بألسنة بأسنة الألسن ويتعادون ويتباغضون من أجل اختلاف يسوغ فيه الاجتهاد. And they are not what? They are not speaking and arguing between themselves with their tongues. And they are showing each other hate and enmity because of a matter which khilaf can occur regarding it. فَإِنَّهُمْ وَإِنْ اخْتَلَفُوا, if they do differ and dispute one another, if they differ and they discuss in a matter, فِيمَا يَخْتَلِفُونَ فِيهِ فِيمَا تَقْتَضِيهِ النُّصُوصَ حَسْبَ أَفْهَامِهِمْ فَإِنَّ هَذَا أَمْرٌ فِيهِ سِعَةٌ وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ. If they differ between themselves in a matter which the text has come to them on an understanding, which is a mujtahid, a person of knowledge, he looked at the text and his understanding reached that, another mujtahid should not rebuke him for it. فَإِنَّ هَذَا أَمْرٌ فِيهِ سَعَةٌ وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ. Meaning, he can refute him on it, on say this is not the right view, this is the right discussion, but it should never break the sufuf and the lines of the believers. والمهم, what is important is ائتلاف القلوب, is to bring the hearts together. واتحاد الكلمة, and to unite the word. ولا ريب, and without a doubt. أن أعداء المسلمين, the enemies of the Muslims. يحبون, they love. من المسلمين, they love from the believers. أن يتفرقوا, that disunity occurs between them. سواء كانوا أعداء يصرحون بالعداوة أو أعداء يتظاهرون بالولاية للمسلمين. Whether they, those people who are our enemies, who clearly tell us that they are our enemies, or those enemies who pretend that they have love for the Muslims and the Muslimin and Islam, they will also want that we become into groups and disunity occurs between us. وهم ليسوا كذلك, and they are not like that. They are lying when they show that to us. They are lying. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said something very powerful. And he told us the natija, the results that furqa brings, this unity. The things that it brings, brothers, is adabullah, the punishment of Allah. وَلَعْنَتُهُ, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's curse. وَسَوَادُ الْوُجُوهِ وَبَرَاءَةُ الرَّسُولِ, it causes these following: punishment from Allah, the curse of the Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the faces being dark in the day of judgment, because Allah said يَوْمَ تَبْيَضُّ وُجُوهُ وَتَسْوَدُّ وُجُوهُ, in the same page when Allah said وَاحْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. And Abdullah ibn Abbas said about that ayah, about those whose faces are going to be shining and they're white, and those whose faces are darkened, Abdullah ibn Abbas said الَّذِينَ بِيَضَّتْ وُجُوهُهُمْ هُمْ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَعَةِ, those people whose faces are going to glow and shine are the people of the sunnah, أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ وَالْجَمَعَةِ. وَالَّذِينَ اسْوَدَّتْ وُجُوهُهُمْ, and those people whose faces are going to be darkened are who? هم أهل البدعة والفرقة. They are the people of innovation and the people of what? Disunity. Every time you see أهل البدعة, what do you see with them? أهل البدعة والفرقة. Disunity is not with أهل السنة. Disunity is a characteristic that never disconnects from the people of innovation. Because everyone wants to use his logic, a logic they can't unite upon it. Because they have no center point, a source which they come back to that governs their affairs and that brings a solution to their problems. They don't have that. Everyone's using his brain, and then you see them breaking into even smaller groups and smaller groups. Whereas the people of the Sunnah, Ahlul Sunnah, whenever they differ on a matter, they say, let's take it back to the Kitab and take it back to the Sunnah, and let's take it back to the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. وَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. That's what they say.